Predictions and what to expect for E3 2019 when it comes to Halo Infinite. Stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. How's it going, everybody? Kevin here once again, give you another gameplay commentary. This time we're doing a little more speculation kind of stuff when it comes to E3 at 2019 this year for Halo Infinite. As we do know, it's going to be coming around June 9th, that's Sunday, which, trust me, I will be streaming my live reactions to that press conference, so keep in mind for that. Just make sure to subscribe to the channel so you stay up to date with anything like that. Leave a comment down below what your thoughts are going to be for what you would like to see for E3 2019. It could even spark another conversation for another video. If you're new to the channel or you like these kind of news or speculation kind of videos, please make sure to tap that like button. Let me know you want to see some more content like this. So let's get right into the video here. With the Microsoft press conference happening Sunday, June 9th, that's a little bit about a month away, I am getting more and more excited for what we're going to see for Halo Infinite. Now, I'm trying to keep my expectations realistic, as it probably is going to be a little bit more information about a year before its actual release, so they're probably not going to show too much. But this might be a little bit of a special situation, since this Halo game is the most amount of time they've spent developing and creating a new Halo game. We have a brand new engine that we're going to be getting for this. This is the longest development period that 343 has ever had. I think maybe even longer than Bungie ever had when it comes to developing a Halo game. So we might actually see a little bit more than we've seen previously at the E3 event year before the actual release of the game. But what I'd like to do is take you guys through a trip to memory lane to kind of understand what we should expect when it comes to E3 2019 this year for Halo Infinite. Alright, so let's start back off with Halo 4, since that was the very first Halo developed by 343. And I typed in, you know, Halo 4 E3 2011, which since the game released at 2012. And when you click on that link right there, you get this trailer right here, which is basically was the announcement trailer. You can see right here of just Master Chief busting through, but you do get to see his new armor set. They're also on the ship that was left off back in Halo 3, and just kind of a general idea of just like, this is going to be Halo, and that's about all you really know. They don't really go much depth about exactly what you're seeing. You do get to see the sticky launcher right there, which is the first time you've seen it in the game. And then basically kind of shows you're going off to Requiem, so you get a little bit of sense of the story as well, which we didn't really get a whole lot of that when it came to Halo Infinite last year, when it was just the announcement, just saying, hey, the game is happening. We didn't really get anything about the, you know, the story, the tone, the narrative, or anything like that. Luckily, we have some great researchers in the Halo community that were able to point out that the game is going to be probably taking place on Installation 07, and there's a lot of possibilities of storytelling when it comes to that, so that's very exciting. If you guys want to look more into that, I will link a video in the description down below to my information that was found through the Halo community about the details about where this game may go for Halo Infinite. But you can see right there a little bit of a trailer, a little bit of knowing what the story is going on there, but nothing much. Really short, quick, to the point. You only really get about 15-20 seconds of actual like Master Chief. And if you look at this also, you can see that 2012 was the first time we actually got any gameplay trailer, so I would not expect to have any gameplay happening for this E3 2019 for Halo Infinite, because obviously so much is still subject to change. There's so much there that they still need to kind of iron out before they even start showing it to anybody. I do feel though we will get an announcement for the flighting program when it comes to Halo Infinite. We're definitely going to need at least a year of testing this game out to fully get what we want and what we expect for a Halo game. And so we expect maybe an announcement for the flighting program or just better details of something about that. Now, Halo 5, the year before it released, the announcement for it back in 2014, another trailer that we're going to show for that, because they had the announcement trailer back in 2013. It just kind of showed Master Chief in a desert. That's all we really got. Very similar to it for Halo Infinite. And for Halo 5 the next year, it kind of a little overshadowed by the MCC. And all we really got was just a trailer that mainly showed MCC clips, but with a dialogue with the Arbiter and Locke talking between each other. As you can kind of see, if you kind of scroll through here, you can see Locke, you know, kind of in the shadows, kind of observing, learning about the Master Chief and things like that. Obviously, none of this really happened in the game. But you can see that we really didn't get much in the way of Halo 5 gameplay or visuals or anything like that. But of course, it did get overshadowed by the announcement of the MCC and gameplay of the MCC being played. We did also get a trailer for the multiplayer, which I'm sure a lot of people are very concerned about. Though with this trailer, it's a cinematic trailer to kind of give you an idea of what to expect when it comes to this. Something flashy, kind of get your hopes up. Obviously, probably because, you know, they didn't really have any gameplay ironed out yet of actually being able to show very well, and so they did a much more cinematic version like this right here. So I would maybe expect something along those lines. I would expect 343 to really kind of copy their techniques that they did for Halo 5's marketing, because Halo 5's marketing was fantastic. I was so hyped for Halo 5's story. I thought it was gonna be like the greatest thing ever, you know, but turns out not so much. And it wasn't until 2015, the year of Halo 5's release, when we finally got this gameplay demo of the campaign. And then I think we did also get a little bit of what the multiplayer was going to look like and kind of play a little bit, but it was more flashy, kind of like the cinematic one I just showed you. It wasn't really exactly gameplay itself, because really with multiplayers, things are subject to change right up until release. And so they're not going to give you guys too much, obviously. So again, like I said, the amount of time 343 has had to polish up Halo Infinite, I can understand why they would take the time to even show a little bit more than you would probably expect. So ultimately, what am I going to be expecting to see when it comes to Halo Infinite for 2019 at E3? Well, one, I think it's definitely going to be the tone of the campaign. I think we're going to see a lot more of that kind of gameplay, which we may not even see gameplay as it. As you've seen from the previous years of Halo releases, the year before the game's actual release, we only get like a little bit of a teaser and a little bit of a note of like the tone and the feel of the game. And so they did say they were going to mention a lot more about how they used Halo CE as a bit of an inspirational point. This is almost like a spiritual reboot of Halo, which can be very interesting in what they mean by that, because there's a lot of things you can take from the classic games, which may not work today, but you can also take some things from the newer games, which probably the fans don't like, but they probably had some really good aspects that they could utilize as well. So it's really kind of up in the air what we're going to see. So what I think they're going to do is just trying to make a statement about what their goal is with Halo Infinite. You know, is this going to be like a spiritual reboot? Is this going to be a new direction? Is this going to be something they're going to give us, I think, just a general sense of what to expect when it comes to this game? Maybe even talk about a little bit of the gameplay mechanics that they know they're going to, you know, hold true, like what they do, no sprint or something like that. Maybe even show off a little bit of customization. I mean, we did have the last social stream at 343 of 2018, Chris Lee, the lead of the FPS genre of 343, stated how they're going to take a lot of inspiration from the Reach style customization. So I could imagine maybe even see a little bit of that as well, but I would not expect to see like full gameplay demos or even multiplayer stuff. I think more just kind of give you some tone. It definitely going to be some kind of cinematic trailer to kind of give you guys an idea, a sense of what to expect when it comes to Halo. I wouldn't expect a full-blown gameplay demo on stage live in front of everybody watching, the world watching. Probably not that, but something to give you guys some hope about this is where we're taking, this is the direction we're taking Halo, and come along for the ride if you want to see more. My expectations are, E3 might even open up with the announcement of Halo Infinite and just kind of showing some more visuals of it, but give you a more tone of the gameplay campaign. And I think maybe at the very end, give you just like a little teaser of what the multiplayer might look like to kind of get all our hopes up, because we're sure everyone's gonna be wondering what that is. And I have a feeling probably Bonnie Ross is gonna step out on stage, or somebody from 343 is gonna step out on stage and kind of give you the idea of what they're trying to capture when it comes to Halo Infinite. Because basically, when you think about it, the general gaming public doesn't know as much as we do right now when it comes to Halo. You know, we do know that they're trying to grab CE as an inspirational point, but, you know, an average Joe gamer who plays Red Dead and Destiny or something like that probably doesn't really know that, you know, because we've dug through the weeds and tried to find as much information as possible for you guys on this channel. And so I think they're probably mention a little bit about that, but then also probably point out some gameplay aspects that they're looking to stick true to, but not actually show. And I think that's probably going to be the whole thing. I think it's going to be kind of going like, what's the power of the new Xbox, whatever they're going to call it, because we do know that once the Xbox conference last year was winding up, they were saying they're getting ready for the new gen console. So I would expect new gen console to be announced along with it being with Halo Infinite, utilizing the power of this, all that little PR's talk right there. But I think that's what we're mainly going to be seeing when it comes to E3 2019. If you guys have any other ideas, let me know in the comment section down below. I'd love to read all the comments and try to reply to most of them as well. It might even spark a whole new video topic to talk about for this, guys. But so, thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. If you're new to the channel, want to stay up to date with anything Halo related, please remember to tap subscribe with the bell, because we keep up to date with anything going on with Halo, Halo Infinite, MCC, Halo 5, all that good stuff. If you like this video, kind of video of more discussing topics about Halo, make sure to tap that like button. Let me know you want to see some more content like this. And you guys are new to the channel or missing any content for me, check out the videos on the screen right now. I'll catch you on the next video. Peace out.